Okay, it's tile day here at the bathroom that we're remodeling. The walls are all done. In a previous video, I showed how I prepared all this. Now, when it comes time to tile, I'm actually working alone today, and there's four flights of stairs between me and the wet saw where I'll be doing the cuts. So I'm not going to have too much time to film this, but let me just start with this. When you're laying out the tile, the first thing you want to do is mark on the wall so you don't get confused, because believe me, it's easy to get confused. Mark on the wall, notes to yourself, where you're starting, where the pattern, you know, will begin and end. Little things like, I want to remind myself that I have a shelf here and here. Little things like that are easy to forget. So this tile, when I laid it out, this is an important point to know, actually. It's an Italian tile, and often the tile stores will sell it as a 12 by 24 tile, but in reality, it's 23 and change inches, and that can have an effect when you're laying it out, because as you come to the end, in this case, we'll be using a bullnose tile, and it'll be on the end here. So when I come to this end, if it isn't actually 24 inches or close to it, as an American or an English tile would be, then the layout can suffer. And in this case, you know, I am going to end up with a little bit of a small piece here. I really have no choice. No matter how I change the layout, there's going to be an awkward piece. However, that will be covered mostly by the shower door, so I'm not too concerned about it. When you're starting the first row, it's important to get a dead level. And one method of doing that would be to actually start in the second row, put a ledger board up and screw that into the wall, and then start your tile on top of this ledger board. And that's a perfectly fine method. In this case, however, my shower pan is almost dead nuts level, so I think I'm gonna be able to work off of that this time, but that isn't always the case. As soon as I mix up my thin set, I'm gonna put mesh tape across these seams, and I will tape those seams as I go. And so that's really getting started here. We've marked our layout. I want to be careful when I'm doing the layout. I have the shower valve up here. I want to try to avoid having this valve end in the middle of a tile, because that's a pain in the ass to cut out. So I have it laid out so that there will be, this ends up on a corner of four different tiles, so that'll work out all right. Up here, I may not be as lucky, but it is what it is. So so that's where we are right now. We're gonna get started. I gotta set up the wet saw, and I got a lot of work ahead of me. I wanna set the end of my tile run first, just so I know where I'm ending up. So even before I've mixed up the thin set, I've cut around the tub where I need to on this trim tile, and make sure you put the floor tile down, even though the floor is not done yet, and add a space. Have little spacers there in between the wall tile and the floor tile, because you want the wall tile to go on top of the floor tile if at all possible. Okay, I mixed up the thin set. We're using a white tile. We're going to use a white thin set. The reason is, if we use a darker thin set, like a gray, it potentially could bleed through sometimes the tile, but also the grout, which is going to be a light color grout. So using a light color tile, use a white thin set. Darker tile, use a dark thin set. It's roughly the consistency of mayonnaise, all right? And just watch it, because it can dry out. I don't mix up more than half a bucket of thin set when I'm working alone like this. Got my notch trowel. So we're just gonna be applying that to the wall and starting our first row of tiles, which needs to be dead nuts level. I am gonna go off the pan this time, only because the pan is pretty much level. There's a slight adjustment in this corner here, but not too bad. Got the first row set, basically level. You know, these Italian tiles are often just a little bit off from each other, so it is something to be aware of, that the dimensions are not, you know, super exact. So as you go up, just keep checking level. Honestly, it's more important that the eye see it as level than it is perfectly level necessarily, but I try to get it as level as possible. So this first row, we'll just let that set up just a little bit. I'll take a quick break. And then we'll start going up the wall with a pattern. Now this pattern, the next tile will overlap this one, these two, I should say. So it's a running bond pattern. And so we have to just remember where we are in the pattern. So the next one will overlap, and then the third row will be the same as the first row. I did tape the joint, so that's all set up, and that'll dry before I even get there. So we're moving along. Incidentally, in another video, previous one, you saw me using the back buttering technique to tile. In other words, you apply the thinset to the tile itself, and you still make this pattern, but you apply it to the tile and then apply the tile to the wall. In this case, I'm not doing that. I'm doing the opposite. I'm applying it to the wall first, and then, which is more typical, honestly, and then applying the tile to this. That's really just because the tile are just too big. These are, you know, almost 2 feet long, and it's just, it's too unwieldy to try to back butter. So I change the technique depending on what I'm doing and what the circumstances. You start to see the pattern develop now, so that's called a running bond pattern, and I'm bringing it right around to the other side. I'm continuing to check for level as I go. As I said, these tiles are not exactly perfectly identical to each other. So you do have to make little adjustments here and there. And the wall has dippy-doos as well. So, you know, this wall is coming out slightly here. This wall is also coming out slightly here, actually. So you have to make little adjustments as you go. That's normal and typical. Sometimes I use the spacers, and I use little pieces of cardboard if I need to make just a slight adjustment, because I can pinch them and get the exact dimension that I want. So you have to make the adjustment as you go and just keep it as good as you can. All right, we get to the corner shelf here. All we got to do is back butter the shelf on the edge here. Wipe the excess off. All right, so got that back buttered. Enough on there to smush. And some people like to put a little spacer back here just to tilt the shelf forward. You could do that if you like, but. All right, so we just smush that in there. And I'm actually leaving a slight space just by eye. All right, now I'm just going to wipe off, I'll get a sponge here, but I'm going to wipe off the excess underneath. And then for the next row, we're going to cut around the shelf with the tile. Okay, I finished the shower. I need to get rocking and rolling on the floor now, which I'm not going to have time to show you because I really got to get a move on here. But just want to show you the shower done. We got, you can see the pattern, the running bond pattern. Had to cut around this growy valve set here, which is kind of a pain, but we got that done. Up here, I used a diamond blade to cut around that pipe. And there's another pipe up here, which I was just able to use the wet saw to get around, because that'll get covered up with an escutcheon. Same with this. And then the edges, this is a bullnose, you know, it's rounded over here. So that goes all the way up. And then up top there's a miter joint, straight joint across the top there. And we have two shelves going here. See if I can step back a little bit and give you the full view. It's about as far as I can step back. All right, so that gives you an idea of how to do the shower with these large tiles and this running bond pattern. It is kind of a hassle to work with these large tiles if your wall has any undulations in it or anything like that, but you can get it done if you just take your time and do it right. Just want to give you a quick update after I've grouted the shower. I haven't grouted the floor yet. I need to do that next. They're two different color grouts, so I had to take a little pause between. But anyway, with the shower done, I was able to grout it, and you see basically what it looks like. There's a little bit of haze left over from the grout, you see, that'll clean up the next day. But that's a tile shower using, these are not quite 12 by 24 inch tiles with a shower pan. They have glass doors, and the bottom here along this edge right here will get a sanded caulk that matches the grout color of the floor tile. And then this area right here on the shower pan, right along the edge where the tile meets the shower pan, we'll also get a white sanded caulk. And occasionally I'll do these corners in a sanded caulk too if I feel there's going to be a lot of flex there. In this case, I don't think it's going to be a problem. But anyway, that's what it looks like all done.